Hi, this is Merrill with Tax Tutor. In this video, I wanted to talk about when you should convert to an S corporation. Now, converting to an S corporation really comes down to the individual facts and circumstances that apply to specifically you and your business. So the things I'm going to cover in this video is a general approach to how I help my clients convert to S corporations and the timing of that. Now, depending on the client situation, I may talk to them and say, you know, this is normally when I convert somebody to an S corporation, but in your specific case, I wouldn't do it because of these reasons, or I'd wait because of these reasons, or other things. So just be known that, kind of a disclaimer on this video, that even though I'm talking about this, it's still important to consult a professional, consult somebody that may apply this conversion differently in your case, or may say, you know what, in your case, it doesn't make any sense. So anyway, just a disclaimer before we start. But assuming that a conversion to an S corporation does make sense to your business, what is the timing of it? When should you convert to an S corporation? When is the right time to do that? So when I consult with my clients, when we talk about converting to an S corporation, it comes down to one principle, one item, and that is right out here. It's reasonable comp, or reasonable compensation. And basically what reasonable compensation is, it is what you would pay somebody to do your job. It can also be based off of the functions and the duties that you perform. I do have a video on reasonable compensation and how best to decide when to take reasonable comp, or how best to determine reasonable comp. So on YouTube, just search for Tax Tutor Reasonable Comp and you'll see my video on how exactly that works. So let's talk about why somebody would convert to an S corporation. Generally, when somebody starts a business, they're going to form an LLC, let's say. That's the most popular form of starting business right now, is to form an LLC. So somebody forms an LLC and they own that LLC 100% themselves. In that example, they are a sole proprietor. Or let's say they own it with a spouse or with friends or somebody else. In that sort of situation, then they're going to be a partnership. So a sole proprietor and a partnership are really the same thing. It just depends on how many people own it. So a sole proprietor is a business that's run and owned by one person. And that entity is gonna file a Schedule C on a 1040. A partnership is an entity, an LLC, that's owned by more than one person, and they're going to file a partnership return. Now, is what happens with a Schedule C is you go and you report the income on your Schedule C and you show all of your income and all of your expenses in there, and you get your net income, and that gets taxed on your return. And guess what? It's subject to two levels of tax. You pay income tax and you pay employment tax on that. So let's say you operate as a partnership instead. So now you have you and your partners and you operate that, and instead of filing a Schedule C, you file a Form 1065. And that Form 1065 generates K-1 statements. And that K-1 statement is your net income from that partnership. And so you take that K-1 statement, you put it on your personal return, and you report the income. And guess what? If you're active in that partnership, you're again subject to two levels of tax. You're subject to income tax, and you're subject to employment taxes. That's the exact same. So if you think of a sole proprietor, if you think of a partnership is made up of sole proprietors, every sole proprietor gets their K-1, then that's kind of the concept that we hit at. So either if you're a sole proprietorship or a single member LLC, those are the same thing. Or if you're a multi-member LLC or a partnership, those are the same thing. You're gonna get this tax on your return, subject to both income tax and employment taxes. The employment taxes is 15.3%. So let's say your sole proprietor makes $100,000. You pay income tax on that $100,000, and then you pay 15.3% of employment tax on that, roughly rounded to $15,000, we'll say. So $15,000 of employment taxes. Let's say you operate as a partnership. You and a buddy own and operate a partnership. That partnership makes $100,000 or makes $200,000, we'll say in this case. You get $100,000 of income, your buddy gets $100,000 of income on a K-1. That K-1 goes into your personal return, you pay income tax, you pay employment tax. If you get $100,000 on that K-1 that's subject to employment tax, again, you're paying $15,000 of employment taxes. This is no different than if you were an employee. However, there's a bit of a difference, right? So if you're an employee working for somebody and you get a W-2 of $100,000, they are withholding the payroll tax before you even see it. However, in that example, the employer is actually paying half of that employment tax. They're paying 7.65%, and the 7.65% you pay is coming out of your paycheck. Now, I mean, you could get into theory and kind of say, you know what, that employer could probably pay you 7.65% more if they didn't have to pay employment tax. So you could argue that the employee is paying the full employment tax because now their salary is less because they're not gonna be paid as much because the employer knows that they have to pay that tax on their behalf. So, you know, one way or another, you're gonna be paying that employment tax at 15.3. So how do you reduce employment taxes? How do you get out of that or reduce that, bring that down a little bit? And the answer is an S corporation. So an S corporation, on an S corporation is only subject to one level of tax, and that is the income tax. So if you are an owner of an S corporation, you'll go in and you will prepare your S corp return. You'll get a K-1 from your S corp, and that K-1 could show $100,000 of income, and that K-1 hits your personal tax return. And guess what? You pay one level of tax. You pay the income tax. There's no self-employment tax on that. So you think, oh, hey, great. I should be an S corp and get out of that employment tax. And you know, if I make $100,000, that would save me $15,000 a year in employment tax. Great day, right? Yeah, but not so fast. The IRS has figured that out. They know that that's a problem. And that's why we have this reasonable compensation standard when it comes to S corporations. So when you are a sole proprietorship or single member LLC, or you're a partnership, a multi-member LLC, you do not take a salary from those entities. It's just not done. Some people will say it's against the law or against tax law or just not in the books to do that. It's not correct. You're not supposed to do that. You can't put yourself on a W-2 and take a W-2 from your sole proprietorship or from your partnership. However, when you are an S corp owner, the rules flip. You are now required to take a salary. You are now required to set yourself up on W-2 because if you don't, you will never pay any employment taxes, and that's basically against tax law. You can't do that. If you were to file an S corp return and have no salary, no wage, no W-2 income coming from that, the IRS eventually would catch up to you, theoretically. They would audit you and they would say whatever you took out of the business should have been your reasonable comp, and they're going to assess employment taxes on all of that. So the way that we do this is we do a reasonable compensation. And again, I have a whole video on how to do reasonable compensation, how to go through that. So that's helpful to go through. But in this video specifically, we're just talking about what is the timing? When do we convert? So now we've talked about if you're a sole proprietor, partnership, everything's subject to employment taxes. If you're an S corp, none of it is subject to employment taxes, but you have to take a reasonable salary, a reasonable compensation. So our first step is to run some kind of report, figure out what reasonable compensation is. Go watch the YouTube video, the Tax Tutor YouTube video on reasonable compensation, and go through that and see how that works. But let's say, just for argument's sake, this could be right, this could be wrong, but let's say you run a reasonable compensation study, and based on the functions that you perform for your business, you get reasonable compensation of, let's say it's $50,000, okay? So $50,000 is now your reasonable compensation that you have to take from your S corporation. Now, if your company, your business, your LLC is making $40,000, then this is net, not gross, this is your net income. So after all of your expenses, what is that net number that you're taxed on? If your net number is $40,000, does it make any sense to convert to an S corporation? Probably not, because your S corporation reasonable compensation is $50,000. That doesn't make any sense. to be making $40,000 and then be required to pay yourself $50,000. That makes zero sense at all. So that's usually what we start advising clients, is we say, okay, well, let's figure out what reasonable compensation is. And then once we know that number, we watch the business income. And as that business income grows and gets better and gets bigger, we start to say, okay, we're getting closer to that reasonable compensation number. And so, okay, so if we get to the $50,000, should we convert to an S corporation at that point? I would say no, because as what's going to happen is when you convert to the S corp, you're now going to take a $50,000 reasonable salary out of that, right? And so you should start to benefit right there. However, when you convert to an S corporation, your expenses go up. You now have to file an S corp tax return, which could cost you several hundred, maybe thousand, maybe more, depending on how complicated your business is and the number of states and all that sort of things that you operate in. That return could cost quite a bit of money to prepare. Also, you have to put yourself on a W-2. You have to put yourself up on salary. If you have no other employees, then it's going to cost you a bit of money, a few hundred dollars, to get yourself set up on W-2 and be paid by W-2 and get that salary coming to you and things like that. So for this purposes, this isn't a hard and fast rule. It's just what I generally advise my clients. I tell them that they want to be making over $10,000 of their reasonable compensation. So if their reasonable compensation is 50, then I would say that when their business starts netting $60,000 of income, now it makes sense to convert to an S corporation. Why is that? Because the difference between $50,000 and $60,000, at $60,000, they're going to be paying about $9,000 of employment taxes as an LLC. Versus if they were an S corporation and they took a $50,000 salary, $50,000 times the 15%, 15.3%, it's about a $7,500 of employment taxes. So the difference between those is about $1,500. That $1,500 could go to pay to have the S corporation return prepared and to have the salary, the W-2s set up and the payroll set up and paid for the payroll and things like that. So that's generally what I advise clients. We first say, okay, what is a reasonable compensation for you in your business? Let's see when we get to be $10,000 more than that and we can have a $1,500 savings per year on the employment taxes, and at that point it will make sense to convert. Now, another thing to discuss here is that by doing this, the income of that business, the self-employment taxes that you're paying into the system is going down, right? So, if you were making $100,000 and paying $15,000 in employment taxes, your credits in the Social Security system are greater than if you are paying yourself a $50,000 salary and only paying employment taxes based on $50,000. So you do have to keep in mind that this strategy will save you money right now, but in the long term, you would get less Social Security benefits. Now you could get into the whole discussion about, okay, if your LLC is making $100,000 a year and you're able to only pay yourself $50,000 and you're saving $7,500 in employment taxes per year, times that by 10 years, that's $75,000. Times it by 20 years, that's $150,000. It depends on how long you have until retirement. It depends on how much you think is going to be in retirement when you get there. It depends on if you can invest that money and get a better return on that money between now and the time you retire. There's all sorts of things that you have to think about. It's good to get with a financial advisor, talk about those things, go through that sort of process as to what's good there. But that is a big consideration to think about and think through, is those reduced retirement benefits when you get to retirement age. So that goes through timing, when to convert to S corp, how that all works. So hopefully that was helpful. And again, check out that video on reasonable comp that's on YouTube there. Just search Tax Tutor Reasonable Comp and that video will show up there. And we'll come back with some more videos on other things. Thank you so much for taking time to watch our videos. I hope that you found them beneficial and helpful to you and your business. At Tax Tutor, we believe that bookkeepers are really great tax preparers. that a client is better served by having the same person do their books and do their taxes together, because that person has a very good understanding of the entire financial situation of that client. So we've developed a program that helps bookkeepers add tax preparation to their business to teach them how to prepare taxes and to get comfortable preparing taxes. If you are interested in learning more about adding tax preparation to your business, visit us at taxtutor.com.